Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Early season, mid-season, late season, it really doesn't matter. The SEC doesn't wait to turn up the intensity. An early season matchup in the Southeastern Conference. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Atlanta and the Georgia Dome. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Georgia is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Georgia State's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
There's a strike complete. He's tackled at the 36-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 36. He makes his way to about the 48.
The Panthers have a lot at stake here, including some possible record-breaking performances. Records and stats are great, but I think to a man, these players say, let's win the game first, and then any accolades we get along with it, that'd be great.
He's scrambling. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
From the 49-yard line, it's second down. Now he's scrambling. They'll make the sack.
Call the loss of 5 yards on the play. That'll bring up third and long.
Team.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
Brown awaits the snap. He'll take it from the 18, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
Decent effort. He's not the type of guy to call a fair catch very often. He does have the ability to make guys miss.
Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. McQueen gets a carry left side. And he's tackled at the 39.
Gain of 12 yards. First down.
A again with the run. He fights forward to about the 40. Just throws this one away. From their own 40-yard line, third down. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. They get 3 yards on the play.
Well, it's a good job here to just secure the football, but he just doesn't have enough speed to turn that into something big.
Carr awaiting the return. Gets to about the 34-yard line. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter.
The Panthers running back left the game earlier with that injury. What we're hearing now, it doesn't look like he's going to be able to return to action today.
That's a great tackle at the 34.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 34-yard line, second down. Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that.
Jennings takes him down for a loss behind the line at the 34-yard line. That brings us third and 10.
It out. He's met immediately. That's a loss of 4 yards.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Pennington is the deep man awaiting the return. Pennington takes it at the 33. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing.
Fakes to the back. Oh, great catch. And down he goes at the 31.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
He's taken down at the 30-yard line. On the run, right side. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Out of bounds at about the 15-yard line.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
He fires. From the 15-yard line, second down. The 10. Tackle at the 2.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and goal.
He tackles him for a loss.
The defense got a great push and blew that play up well behind the line of scrimmage.
That brings him second and goal.
They're at the 6. Second down. Touchdown, Bulldogs. And he hits the PAT.
An 8-play, 52-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
So the score now, 7-0. Georgia is lining up to kick this one off. Carr fields at the goal line. And he's taken down at the 28-yard line.
The Bulldogs are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
Both offenses trying to find their rhythm in that first quarter. Low scoring and close right now. Georgia in front, 7-0.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
And they get nice yardage on that run. It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 32-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. They'll bring him down at the 33.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That'll make it 35.
Going deep, lays it out there. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. And for Johnson, he keeps adding to his awesome career passing totals.
There have been some great passers to come through here. This would be quite an accomplishment.
So after the big pass play, we have a first and goal. He scrambled. They bring him down.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
From the 11-yard line, it's second down. Made at the 13-yard line.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. That makes it 30 more.
Roger, Roger. Hey, check Mike 57. Mike 57.
I got you, punk.
They'll line it up for the field goal. Kicks up, and he's got it. Thomas looks ready to kick this one off. Tackle at the 27. Pickoff return of 19 yards.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Georgia is up 4. And he's taken down at the 29. They'll spread the field with 5 wide.
Check 3, check 3, check 3.
Incomplete pass. Who was the intended receiver on that play? Third down. Check,
from their own 29-yard line. Third down.
Three down,
catches it and hit immediately for a loss. Cummings is the punter. He's pushed out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
There's a flag on the field, and I think I have a good feeling of what this might be.
These are the calls that drive a coach crazy. Senseless penalties can sometimes be the difference between winning and losing the game.
From their own 40-yard line, first down. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
Gets it. He's in space. And they push him out at the 46. They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
Come on, D.
Stepping up, he lets it fly. And they make the stop at the 23. And for Johnson, he's just set a new high watermark for career passing yards here.
Is he the best quarterback they've ever seen around here? You can make a pretty good argument.
It's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Brought down at the 21-yard line. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
His way out to about the 12. Georgia State will take their second time out of the half. First and 10. Ball on the 12-yard line. Slings it to his fullback, and he hits him hard at the 12-yard line.
No gain on the play. That'll bring up second and 11.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 12. And he makes it out to about the 11-yard line.
Gain of one on the play. That'll make it third and nine.
He's tackled at the 2-yard line. This isn't much more than an extra point. It's up, and they tack on 3 points.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Thomas has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Pennington from the 8. He's out to the 30, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 32. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here.
Airing it out long. That
close to being intercepted.
We head into halftime with both offenses struggling. Georgia in front, 7-6.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And, boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three.
Hart has it at the five. He's out to the 30. They'll bring him down at the 37.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up.
Georgia with a one-point lead. He's tackled at the 48-yard line.
That's a gain of 11 on the play. First down.
Tight left, tight left. Four down, four down. 51, Mike. Mike, 51.
Here's an opening. Nice run to the outside.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll bring up second and three.
Bring him down for a loss on the play. It's third down and 5 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Knocked out of bounds around the 44-yard line. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
You know, this offense is doing a pretty good job moving the football. The problem is they're not coming up with touchdowns. The offense coordinator who's been up here next to us, Brad, the booth next to us, he's actually just taken off his headsets, and I think he's going down to the field to be next to the quarterback and the rest of this offense to try to engage with them to realize how important it is to finish these drives.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. With room to work, and down he goes at the 35-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Here we go, here we go. Tight right.
Just throws this one away. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line. He's scrambling. And he's going to come up with a sack.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That brings up third and 12.
concentration to pull it in. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. Brown is waiting for the snap. Brought down at the 26. The Panthers have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team has put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Georgia is up one. The ball is loose. It's picked up. Runs outside for a nice gain. It's second down, six to go. Ball on their own 30. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it better than that.
Over there, Mike 51.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 49.
First down.
Check tight right, tight right, tight right. Pull out there, check the outs out there. Pull down, pull down. 51, Mike. Mike 51.
Slings it. Can't make the tackle. He's in the open. He's at the 40.
That's good for a gain of 17 yards.
Tackle at the 31-yard line. Throws this one away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
So we're looking at another third down here. Georgia up a point. Fires it out. They'll bring him down at the 28. Kicks away, and it's good! Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Gets to about the 24-yard line. And for Gray, he's having himself a pretty good game.
Any coach in the country will tell you, to have a great defensive player, he's got to have intensity and he's got to have an edge to him. This young man has demonstrated that, and I don't know if I've seen anybody play with this kind of effort all year long.
Well, between the sacks, the knockdowns, and just the overall pressure they're putting on this quarterback, this is going to be a game this quarterback's going to want to forget in a hurry.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch, that's fun to see.
That brings them second and five.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Out of bounds, right around the 34.
Well-designed route and a confidently thrown football by the quarterback. You need those things to make any offense work.
You don't want to see me. You don't want it. 57's the mic. Mike 57.
folks. It's neck and neck as we head to the final quarter of play. 10-6, Bulldogs. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. He laterals.
Intelligent, decisive play to pitch it out to the tailback on the option. He had more room to run and picked up some quality yards.
From their own 38-yard line, it's first down. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Tackle made around the 36-yard line.
Called a loss of 2 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 12.
They come out in a five wide set. He fires this one. And he's taken down at the 27-yard line. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down.
You never know what'll happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
That makes it second and 10.
Hey, check Mike 57.
He's on the run. They bring the quarterback down.
That's a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it third and 11.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Deep pass to the end zone. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Strike to the back, no good.
It's always a gamble going for it with so many yards to come up with. But when you're behind, sometimes you have to take risks to get back into a ball game.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Georgia holds a four-point lead. Here's a running play. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game.
That makes it second and six.
He's to the 40. Makes it to the 41.
That's a gain of 9 on the play. First down.
Tight left, tight left. Go down.
Got an opening.
Gain of 12 yards. That makes it first and 10.
To him, and this time they get him in the backfield. From
from the 48-yard line. Second down. Takes it right side. Decent run here, right side. The misdirection play gets him 4 yards. The Panthers taking their first time out of the half. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And they make the stop around the 32-yard line. What a critical first down as time ticks away.
Huge, huge first down. The defense desperately needed a stop there.
Nice run to the left there. McQueen gets 6 yards on the play. The defense puts an end to the no-huddle offense by calling timeout. This is the eighth play of this drive. Run up the middle.
Yeah, the defense knew that this offense was trying to work the clock. When you want to work the clock, you're going to run the football. It puts a lot of pressure on the offensive line to get low and drive that defensive line back. And that's what they were able to do there to give the running back enough room to pick up that first down.
Gains his way to the 10-yard line.
That's good for 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
The play clock's at zero. They took too much time.
Offense.
And he hits the PAT.
A quick update now. Here's Reese.
A great matchup unfolding in Miami. And for Oklahoma State, they reach the end zone with an aerial dart. McCarty flashed the sticky fingers as he's hauled in a touchdown. Oh, lucky seven. In another game, we take you down to Ruston. And for Louisiana Tech, they've won two straight. The Bulldogs take it by five.
17-6 in our game here.
Deep to return.
Georgia ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. Room around the corner. He's pushed out of bounds at the 19-yard line.
For Georgia, they've been getting into the backfield quite a bit. Good pass rush by these guys today. This offense's best bet seems to be to keep the ball on the ground.
Well, they are running it pretty well, so that wouldn't be a bad thing. You take the yards however you can get them.
And it always helps your offense when your defensive teammates are playing this well. Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening.
That's a great tackle at the 35.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down.
Taken down
right around the 44-yard line. Check three.
That makes it second and two.
Spikes the ball.
That'll bring up third and two.
From their own 44-yard line, third down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five-wide outlook.
Steps out of bounds
around the 44-yard line.
That'll bring up fourth and one.
And they'll try one last pass here to pad the stats, but that's about all they're going to get right here. He's going to air it long.
You can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. And so that's going to do it. The Bulldogs take this one 17-6. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.